documenting 50 years of Indian independence, how did you conceive your photographs?
Well, my photographs actually don't document independence or India in that way. When I take pictures, they're very close to my own life. And if you can say it's a documentation of things around me as I've grown, and in contemporary India, I suppose that would be one slice of it. This show itself goes all the way from people who shot in the 40s in similar ways, I suppose, all the way to today where me and my friends are doing similar things. So it's samplings of various kinds of photographies over the years, over the last 4 or 5 decades.
Right. Okay, photography is a creative art.
My work has less of news, it has more of clues. It's the kind of work where you need to let your eye go across the frame, wait a little, ponder a bit, and then a message may or may not come through. I don't go and shoot news, I don't go looking for disasters or political handshakes or any such thing. It's very slow, reflective photography. Well, India is a very complex country, and it's very old, it's very rich, and it can't be put into any one particular show, try as you might. So I don't think that's ever been the effort. But in terms of the way people from the rest of the world have been looking at us till now, there's been a curatorial problem, really, because India tends to be shown sometimes in magazines and newspapers in a particular way. I don't think it's the fault of any photographer or that the viewer is not bright enough to understand that it's only a particular kind of image that's being shown. But that is the kind of commercial image that's been required from the developing world, really. That is all changing now. Today, Indian photography as a body is very new. There are very intelligent, contemporary, sensitive photographers at work, who don't just show one picture of an event. They have large bodies of work which talk to you about the country and how they live their lives and what is important to them. So in that way, certainly the world is looking at Indian photography and gaining more insight into India today than they were before, certainly.
And what is the Indian photography, what's the role of it in the world?
I don't think there's any conscious effort from Indian photographers as a whole to do very much, because I can safely say that if you look at the total amount of work done in the last 40 or 50 years, it's very rich and there are some very fine photographers. But there isn't really a Indian photography tradition, because what we have lacked, unfortunately, is the ability to show each other our work, to have an archive, to have fora where people can see work very frequently of different kinds of photographers. That's definitely been lacking. And so I wouldn't say that as a whole there is any impetus in any direction, no.
So what do you think of this exhibition? Do you think, are you satisfied with the way it's turned out finally?
Yeah, it's hanging very well. It's a very good looking exhibition. No exhibition can be perfect or can be comprehensive. This one also has some gaps, I would say. There are some very important photographers who are not represented. But I don't think that was really the intention, that it should be looking at everybody's work. It's a curatorial aspect. The gentleman, Michael Hoffman, who curated it, spent time here. He came for a year, looked around, traveled all over the country, and then has managed to find the best of work from people like Arthur Bresson to people who are working today. So it spans a very long period of time, and it spans very different aspects of how foreign and Indian photographers have looked at this country. So for a person who walks into the show who hasn't been studying photography for a very long time, he'll find it very refreshing. For people who've studied photography, they find that almost all the images are very familiar. So it's not a new show, but at the same time, the fact that they're familiar, I think, is a strength, because the photographers have given their best work, which has been published again and again and again. So that shows that there is a fair degree of goodwill from the photographers for this exhibition. Well, it's a privilege to be exhibiting with people like Arthur Bresson, I would say.
Thanks.
Welcome.
One more question I want to show you is, the medium is a photography, and there are pictures over here, the photographers, they put it there, which plays a very important role in depicting the society. does it help in any way, either like in a, as these pictures have been shown in, outside of the world, does it affect our society as such? Any improvement or any upliftment of anything?
No, I don't think so. I don't think. The link between creative art and the intention to change society is it's a very tenuous link, really. I don't think when a person is creating anything, he is consciously trying to move society in any particular direction. It's more a concern and an expression which comes from within you. And it's up to the viewer, actually. If that person gets touched a bit and something changes within him or her and the thought process of somebody starts moving in a different direction, that's valuable, but I don't think there's ever a conscious effort to directly change. And I mean, for that you would require violent protest or something.